that the 8 should be multiplied by this 3, and they think it's 8 times a negative 3, but this reads 8 and it reads minus whatever is in those parentheses, 8x minus, or add the opposite, or change and multiply each of these by a negative 1. So I have a minus 3x here, and then a minus 2, because this plus sign becomes a minus sign. Finally, combine your like terms. 8 take away 3 is 5x, and then bring down your minus 2, and you're all done. This is simplified. On the other hand, this next problem just has a plus sign. It asks you to take this 3y and add whatever's in here. Well, the 3y can be combined with the 4y for a total of 7y, and you bring down the minus 7. Again, that's because this was plus whatever this is. Well, plus a negative 7 is the same thing as minus 7. Be careful on this next problem. This minus sign right here is asking you to change the signs of both of these. So the 2x will become a minus 2x. The 6 will become a minus 6. And now I'm going to bring down, I'm very vertical in my approach when I'm doing some algebra, and that is to show myself where my like terms are. So here, I have x terms that are like terms. 6x, take away 2x, is going to give me 4x. I'm going to then put the 3y, because it's in alphabetical order now, and then finally last, the constant. Mind you, I will not mark you down if you put the 3y first, and then the 4x next, and then the minus 6. That's not going to happen, but typically we work a range of polynomial in alphabetical order, depending on the power of the exponent. So, x is before y's. Again, you should probably pause and do these next three on your own. And then come back and see what I do. So in number 27, this minus sign here is telling me to make this a minus 8x and then a positive 5y. I'm going to go ahead and copy the 4y and the minus 7x that's in front so I can tell myself to collect the x terms, a negative 7 and a negative 8 totals to be a negative 15 of those. And then 4y and 5y totals to be 9 of those y's. All right, I'm going to just move a little faster. So 2y minus v will take away the 3y, but will add the v and subtract the w. So all the signs got changed. So watch. The minus v and the plus v are gone. The 2y minus 3y gives us a negative 1y. You do not need that negative 1. And then just don't forget to bring down this minus w right here, and there's your answer. Again, it could be a negative 1y minus w, or it could be a negative y minus w. And you know, I just was noticing that w is before. It could also be a negative y, w minus. Okay, finally, a lot of people think 7 minus 3 is 4. 7 minus 3 is 4. But in this problem, you've got to distribute this negative 3 times the x and get a negative 3x. And the negative 3 is in front of this grouping symbol, so the negative 3 times 4 is a minus 12. So you cannot initially call this 7 minus 3 is 4. It's also order of operations. Adding and subtracting is the last thing you do in order of operations. What we did is we multiplied here. So finally, the negative 3x will come down, and then the positive 7 take away 12 will give me a negative 5. There's my answer. Negative 3x minus 5. Let's go back up here. These are a little bit harder problems. So let's go back up to number 30. So number 30. This is not, let me get my black pen back. squiggly is really called a brace. Next, I have a minus sign here in front of these square brackets, so everything in this square bracket has to have its sign changed because this is asking me to subtract or add the opposite or multiply it all by a negative 1. Yes, you could first take 3 minus 5 and get a negative 2. Most of my students just don't want to do that, so I'm going to go ahead and collect at the end. So I'm going to copy my 6 down with the brace in front. This 3 is going to become a minus 3. This 5 is going to become a plus 5. This minus x is going to become a plus x. And now all I have left are the braces. So now that means I've got to collect my like terms. So 6x and 1x is a total of 7x. And then this minus 3 and a positive 5 add to be a positive 2. I'm all done. These are not like terms. My answer turns out to be the binomial 7x plus 2. Again, you might pause to do these next two and see if you get the same thing I do. I'm going to take and copy most everything down. So 2 times the brace, 3. But inside these parentheses, see this minus sign right here? I'm going to make this x a minus x. This positive 8, a minus 8, and this minus 2x, a positive 2x. Here's one thing that I discovered, and that is that people won't waste the pencil lead and the paper to write the steps down. They want to do it in their head. I advocate for you not doing that. So as a matter of fact, I'm going to take the space and the paper off to go ahead and combine inside these braces the like terms. So I've got a negative 1x and a positive 2x adds to be 1x. I could put the 1 or I don't need to. This 3, take away 8, is a minus 5. And now, actually that was supposed to be a brace, but it's just denoting that there's several sets of parentheses in this problem. So there's my brace. So 2 times 1x is 2x, and 2 times a minus 5 is a minus 10. All right, so again, use paper. Don't say to yourself, oh, I want to save paper, and I just want to do this in my head. Be careful, because there's the rounded parentheses here, and then there's the square brackets that I'll do everything in there next, and then finally, these squiggly braces. So do what's in the innermost set of parentheses first. So I'm not applying this minus sign to anything until I'm just down to the braces. So I leave that alone. So I'm going to bring that and the 3 down, bring the square bracket down, bring the x down. But now, finally, I'm going to distribute a negative 2 times the x plus 7. So a negative 2 times x is a negative 2x. A negative 2 times 7 is a negative 14, a minus 14. And I'm down to a square bracket. Bracket, and then squiggly. Again, you know, sometime I've got to combine my like terms, so it is really best practice to go ahead and take this 1x and subtract that 2x and get a minus 1x. It really is your best bet. And bring down the 14. You know, I haven't done anything. All I did is clean up what's inside, so I haven't multiplied that by 3 yet, and I certainly haven't taken the opposite. So all I did was combine these two. So 3 times this would be a negative 3x. And 3 times a minus 14 would be a negative 42. And what I got rid of just now was the square brackets. So I have the squigglies left. And as a result of that, this minus sign right here is asking me to change the sign of these two terms because it's like multiplying by a negative 1. So this will become a positive 3x. And this will become a positive 42. Okay, a couple more hard ones, and then we've simplified algebraic expressions. Again, you might pause to do these on your own before you watch my work, but let's go ahead. First one, not so bad. Inside the square brackets, I've got to take 5 times x and get 5x, and 5 times 4 and get 20. Don't forget that 3 at the end. that's in the second grouping, this grouping, has to have its sign changed, not this one. This one just stays as it is, but when I subtract this 9x minus 66, the 9x will become minus, and the 66 will become positive. Finally, I combine my like terms. 6x minus 9x would be a negative 3 of those x's, and then a negative 46 and a positive 66 would be a positive 20. Okay, finally, this last one is a killer because of all the minus signs. So, go ahead and do it on your own. See how you do. Alright, I'm going to start in the innermost set of parentheses right there, and I'm going to apply this minus sign to those. I'm going to bring down the square bracket, I'm going to bring down all of this. So I've got this minus sign, this brace, this minus sign, that square bracket. And right now I'm getting rid of this sign to these two. So the x will become negative, the 2a will become positive. Bring your minus b down, it's inside the square brackets, right here. You know, while I'm here, I'm allowed to work from left to right, and I'm allowed to go ahead, since this is in rounded brackets and I've got a minus sign here, I'm going to make the a minus a, and the x a positive x, and I've gotten rid of this pair of brackets, but I've got to bring down the brace. Okay, I'm going to now apply this negative sign to what's in these square brackets. So I'm going to take this and change these signs. So this one right here will cause this one to become positive. I'm going to put the brace down and the minus sign down in front. I'm bringing these two down. Again, applying that right there, that's going to make it a positive x. That's going to make this 2a a minus 2a. That's going to make this minus b a positive b. Square brackets are now drawn. I'm going to bring these down, and I'm going to bring my brace down. It's supposed to be a brace. Could combine my like terms. Don't have to. Could just change all of these signs right now because of now the minus sign, the very last minus sign in front of the braces. So I can make this x a negative x. 2a is positive. The b is minus. The minus a is now plus. And the plus x is now minus. Now let's put this down in alphabetical order. 2a plus 1a is 3a. Then let's bring down the minus b, that's alphabetical order. Then I've got this minus x, and minus x is a total of a minus 2x, and I am all done. Again, this is the typical way to write this answer, but I need you to know that if you write these terms in a different order, it would be acceptable to me. So if you happen to put